Hi everyone, and thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how I made this 3D printed robotic arm. To begin, I will show you what my first design and idea of the robotic arm was. I will explain why the final result was very different, and I hope that my mistakes will serve as an experience for those interested in developing their own robotic arms. To control the arm, first I started using an Arduino Uno, but then I found this 16 PWM channel driver on the internet that made my job much easier. This board is very easy to use. We can save the movements of the arm, and as his name suggests, you can control up to 16 servo motors at the same time. We can activate a sequence of movements with an external input on the board. This signal can come from an Arduino Uno or a simple relay. To see the final result of this project, please stay until the end of the video. Okay, now let's move on to the mechanical assembly. I will explain you step by step why I took some decisions, and also I will share the lesson I learned from this project. In the end, you will see that the result was very different from what was planned. The base of the robot was the only part that didn't change. My idea for this design was to install some bearings to support the weight of the arm. I believe that in this part I didn't have any problems because the effort comes from the actual position. One thing that I learned from this project is that before installing any mechanical components on your servo, you need to be sure that the position is 90 degrees. As you can see here, I'm using an Arduino Uno and a potentiometer to calibrate the position of the servo. Here is where I realized that maybe controlling all these servos with an Arduino was not a good idea. Don't forget that all the documentation to make this project will be available in the video description down below. As I was assembling the pieces, I realized that the arm was gaining more and more weight. When I tested the servos one by one, everything worked very well. But when all the servos were connected and I wanted to move something, the arm went crazy. After this, I changed two things. The first one was to reduce the weight of the elements, and the second one was to install a 10 amps power supply. Here are some parts that I changed from the old design. After several tests and some big disappointments, here is the final design of my robot arm. It is not what I thought, and for sure it is not perfect. But at the end, my objective was to have something to play with. This is the final result. There are so many things I need to improve, but I'm happy with my first 3D printed robotic arm. For the moment, I can only make some small and easy sequences. I'm having some problems with the gripper, and I need to do something to avoid the recoil on the movements. And now, let's test it. I hope you liked this video. I will continue working on some new projects, so please stay tuned and consider subscribing.